Welcome to a lesson on rounding decimals. Before we define the formal rules surrounding decimals, though, let's look at several examples to get a better understanding of what's happening when we round decimals. In our first example, we want to round 2.54, or 2 and 54 hundredths, to the tenths place value. Notice how the 5 is in the tenths place value, which means 2.54 would be between 2.5 and 2.6. So to round 2.54 to the tenths place value, we're really asking, is 2.54 closer to 2.5 or 2.6? Let's look at this on the number line. Let's say 2.5 is here and 2.6 is here. Well, we know in the middle here would be 2.55, and we're given 2.54, which would be approximately here. So notice how to the tenths place value, 2.54 is closer to 2.5 than it is to 2.6, which means you round down and 2.54 would round to 2.5, again to the tenths place value. So by rounding, what we're doing is determining whether a given number is closer to one of two numbers based upon a given place value. Let's look at another example. Here we're asked to round 2.77 to the tenths. Notice how, again, the 7 here is in the tenths place value. 2.77 would be between 2.7 and 2.8 to the tenths place value. So right in the middle would be 2.75. We'll notice 2.77 would be approximately here. So to the tenths place value, 2.77 is closer to 2.8 than it is to 2.7, which is the reason why 2.77 rounds to 2.8 when rounding to the tenths place value. Now let's look at two more examples that are a little bit more challenging. Here we're asked to round 8.75 to the tenths place value. Again, this 7 is in the tenths place value, so 8.75 would be between 8.7 and 8.8 when considering only the tenths place value. So 8.7 would be here, 8.8 would be here. In this case, notice how 8.75 would be right in the middle, which means 8.75 is not closer to either of these values, it's right in the middle. In this case, we have a special rule. When other value is right in the middle, we always round up, and therefore 8.75 is going to round to 8.8, again when rounding to the tenths place value. So if the value is right in the middle between two numbers to a given place value, we are going to always round up. Let's look at one more example and then we'll look at our formal rules. Here we're asked to round 8.98 to the tenths place value. We'll notice how we have a 9 in the tenths place value. So 8.98 to the tenths place value would be between 8.9 and 9.0. So 8.9 would be here, 9.0 would be here, right in the middle would be 8.95, and our given value is 8.98, which would be approximately here. And now it's pretty easy to see that 8.98 is closer to 9.0 than it is to 8.9, and therefore we say 8.98 rounds to 9.0 when rounding to the tenths place value. Now let's go and look at our formal rules for rounding, and we'll look at a few more examples. To round our decimal, step 1, we identify the round-off place value. 2, if the digit to the right of the round-off place value is less than 5, we say we round down and do not change the round-off place digit. If the digit to the right is 5 or more, we round up and increase the round-off digit by 1. In either case, we drop all digits to the right of the round-off place value. So again, by rounding, we're determining what number a given number is closer to based upon the round-off place value. So here we want to round 12.1258 to the hundredths place value. So now using our formal rules, let's first identify the hundredths place value, which should be here. The digit to the right of this 2 is what I call the decision maker. If it's a 5 or more, we round up. If it's 4 or less, we round down. Because it's 5, we round up, so we change the 2 to a 3. which means the given value rounds to 12.13 to the hundredths place value. So keep in mind from our previous examples, this tells us that if we had a number line, notice how the given value is between 12.12 and 12.13. Because this rounded to 12.13, the given value is closer to 12.13 than it is to 12.12. Next, we're asked to round 5.1249 to the tenths place value. So notice how the 1 is in the tenths place value. The digit to the right is a 2. Because it's a 4 or less, we round down, which means 5.1249 is going to round to 5.1 when rounding to the tenths place value. Notice how whenever we're rounding to a given place value, the rounded value should only contain the place value in which we're rounding to. And let's look at one more example. Here we're asked to round 16.098274 to the 10,000ths. Let's be careful identifying the correct place value. We have the tenths, hundredths, thousandths, 10,000ths would be this 2. The digit to the right is a 7. Because it's a 5 or more, we round up. So we change the 2 to a 3. So this would round to 16.0983, which again means the given value is closer to 16.0983 than it is to 16.0982. If we look at the number line and only consider the 10,000ths place value, the given number is closer to this value here than it is to this value here. Okay, I hope you found this lesson helpful.